Hi guys, welcome to AndroGuider. When Narendra Modi was re-elected in 2019, his government said that they would begin 5G trials in just 100 days. But after being in power for over 800 days, 5G is still nowhere in the foresight. Now, of course, COVID-19 is the primary reason behind the delay, but there are still a lot of other things that the government has to look after to ensure that there is no further delay in the rollout of 5G. And that's what we are going to cover in today's video. Before we begin, make sure you are subscribed to the channel and like this video if you find it helpful. Let's dive in. Let's start off with the hardware that is necessary for 5G. Firstly, it is important that the network towers are able to send data between themselves at 5G speeds. At the moment, over 70% of India is connected via copper cables. Copper was good enough for 2G and 3G, but for the high data speeds that 5G offers, we need to transition to optical fiber. Right now, only 30% of India's network towers are connected via optical fiber. This needs to double to 60% to serve 5G requirements. Now, optical fiber is not only necessary for 5G, but it's also important for good 4G speeds. So, when the government had to roll out 4G in 2016, they introduced a policy known as right of way. This policy had regulations for network providers like Airtel and Jio for laying down optical fibers, and it also had the details of the charges that these network providers have to pay to the government as installation fees. What you have to keep in mind here is that this policy was leveraged by the central government. The center recommended that the states adopt this policy as is, but some state governments took the freedom and made changes to this policy. For example, the one-time rate that is recommended by this policy for the installation of 1 kilometer of optical fiber is rupees 1000. But in 2018, the Kerala government used to charge rupees 75,000 for this. Due to the lack of uniform pricing across the states, it becomes harder for the network providers to plan their infrastructure and how they must spend their budget. Needless to say, if uniform pricing is not there, there would be delays due to planning, and this will inevitably push the 5G rollout. So this is where the central government has to step in, and it has to ensure that more states adopt the uniform pricing. Fortunately, the Modi government has made some progress here. In 2020, many state governments, in fact 7 of them, including Kerala, agreed to the uniform pricing. Now, let's say the network providers manage to overcome the obstacle for the pricing, and they also figure out a plan for installing the optical fibers. The next challenge that they face is procuring the equipment that is required for the 5G towers. Huawei and ZTE are among the handful of organizations that can supply 5G equipment to the network providers. But the problem is that they are Chinese organizations. In 2019, United States alleged that China was using Huawei to spy on other nations. This led to the US banning Huawei from supplying networking equipment to its network providers. And later on, several US allies, including Canada and Australia, also followed the footsteps of the US. Since India is a close friend of the United States, many people believe that India will also take a similar stance, and it will also blacklist Huawei. So, what the Indian government did was, it set up 2 separate committees to investigate the claims of the US and actually determine whether there is any close association between the Chinese government and Huawei. So, while these committees were working on their reports and deliberating the issue, we were hit by the coronavirus pandemic. So, that kind of slowed down things a bit. And then later in June 2020, India and China engaged in the Gulwanwali clash. Several Indian soldiers ended up being killed in this clash. So that obviously upset the Indian government. And then there were some reports from government sources quoting that India will blacklist Huawei and ZTE from supplying the networking equipment. Now, there isn't any official report at this point from the government stating whether Huawei and ZTE can participate in the in supplying the 5G equipment. But if the government sources are anything to go by, then that will happen. And in fact, that is a likely scenario because we have already seen how the Indian government has banned several Chinese apps. So this might actually happen. What we do know for sure is that the Indian government will be releasing a list of companies who can supply the 5G equipment. That list is due to be released later in June. At the time of recording this video, that list hadn't been released. But whenever that list is released, I will pin a comment down below with all the relevant details and let you guys know what is up and whether Huawei and ZTE would be participating in the 5G equipment. Let's put the political tensions aside for a moment and talk about what I think is the biggest roadblock in the 5G rollout. And that is social bias. When the coronavirus pandemic was at its worst in India, there were several conspiracy theories floating around why COVID-19 is spreading so vastly and why is it spreading so quickly. One of those theories was that it is 5G that is leading to the spread of COVID-19. Now, this might sound illogical at first, but this theory ended up getting so much traction that the Indian government actually had to step out and issue a statement to debunk these rumors. And more recently, Bollywood celebrity Juhi Chawla also filed a case in court seeking certification whether 5G is fit for the humankind. What she's basically trying to assert here is that she wants a certification from the court that 5G doesn't pose any harm to the humans and animals. Now, to Juhi Chawla's credibility, there are some reports which suggest that 5G may pose a threat to the humankind. But the World Health Organization has repeatedly issued statements and clarified that there are no conclusive studies that actually show that the radio frequencies from 5G pose a threat to the mankind. So it really depends on how you take that. You can either be on the side that is that believes that 5G is beneficial for us and it doesn't do any harm to us, or you can be on the other side of it where you believe that 5G is a threat to us and it shouldn't be rolled out in India. The problem here is that we wouldn't be able to roll out 5G until the side who believes that 5G is harmful for us, until they believe that 5G is beneficial for us. Now, I'm not telling you which side you should choose and whether side B should come to side A. I'm no one to tell you that. But until we reach a general consensus that 5G is beneficial for us and it doesn't pose any risk, only then can we roll out 5G for everyone in India. Until then, we may get more such cases similar to that of Juhi Chawla's, and only God knows how long would these cases take to sort out. So until we reach a general consensus, the 5G rollout would not take place. The fourth and the final obstacle is the price. That is, 5G should be affordable for us as end consumers. Now, before the public 5G rollout takes place in 2022, the Indian government will hold an auction where they will sell the different spectrums for 5G. What do I mean by a spectrum? Well, a spectrum is a set of radio frequencies that a network provider can use to send 5G signals to your device. So, as you would know that there is always a base price in an auction, and the government body that is responsible for setting the base price for this 5G auction is the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. They are more popularly known as TRAI. So, when TRAI released the base price for the 5G auction, the Indian network providers came together and they deemed the price as unaffordable. They said that if these prices are to continue, then it will make 5G unaffordable for the end consumers, and the Indian network providers will also have to spend a lot on their end, and this will also lead to delays in the 5G rollout. So, after all this happened, a report was issued by the Indian Parliament to TRAI, in which they said that the TRAI must revisit the prices for the 5G spectrum, and they must focus on consumer interest and the socio-economic goals of our country. So it's likely that Tri will discount the base prices for the 5G spectrum further, and this will make 5G more affordable for us as end consumers. To bring down the operational costs for 5G further, Tri has suggested the implementation of an active infrastructure sharing policy. As the name suggests, this policy will allow the Indian network providers to share their electronic infrastructure. In theory, this will bring down the operational costs, and it will also improve the network coverage. So for us as end consumers, this will mean that 5G will become cheaper. Now, one thing that I have to mention here is that the Indian network providers already do share some of their resources, but with the implementation of this policy, they would be able to share even more of their resources. So as they would have to build less of their own network towers, let's say that Jio owns a network tower and it gives Airtel the permission to use that network tower. So in that case, Airtel wouldn't have to spend the money and build its own tower. So that's how the operational costs will reduce and 5G will become more affordable. Right now, the active infrastructure sharing policy has been recommended by Tri to the government. It hasn't been implemented yet, but the government is likely to accept it. To summarize, the Indian government faces four major challenges. Firstly, it has to convince more state governments to adopt the uniform pricing for installing optical fibers. Secondly, it has to determine the sources for procuring the 5G equipment. Thirdly, people have to be educated more about the pros and cons of 5G. And finally, the government has to look after the pricing. They have to ensure that 5G is cheaper for us as end consumers. And if the government implements the active infrastructure sharing policy, that will help in bringing down the operational costs for the network providers. So there you have it. Those were all the challenges that the Indian government faces in rolling out 5G to the public. Now, the Indian government has stated that they will be able to roll out 5G in early 2022, and the auctions for 5G are expected to be held in November or December of 2021. So let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Do you think that the Indian government would be able to meet those deadlines? And if you have any other thoughts, do put those down below in the comment section below. It took us a long time to compile this video. So if you like this video, then make sure you hit that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. And yeah, share this video if you can. So thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day. Take care. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.